Today, we will be going over the failure modes and repair of a PowerFlex 755 variable frequency drive. We have gone ahead and removed the cover, and we will show you what caused this drive to fail. As you can see internally, there is a large layer of black metallic dust that is covering the main power board of this drive. And as you can see, it is presently right on top of the power module, which are these pins here. In this case, the power module being an IGBT. So we are going to go ahead and remove this board and get to the bottom of the damage that is present on it. So here we've removed the control basket and disconnected the wires internally. And now we can remove the board and take a look at what damage is present. So the first thing we'll take a look at are the connections of the IGBT module and look for any damage. Using denatured alcohol will help us get a better look at the damage. And as we can see, there's some scorching and sparking on this side of the module. We'll go ahead and flip it over to take a look at the other side. Again, we can see what appears to be some burn marks to the side of the IGBT and one of its legs. So in this case, it appears that the drive had some sort of failure on the output, but we believe the cause was due to this big layer of black dust. So we're going to go ahead and continue to clean this board, and then we will come back to a new board install. So now we've got the new board fully installed. We're going to go ahead and take this away here. We've got all the connections made, and we're ready to go to our next phase of testing, which is attaching the control basket, putting the case on, and then doing a live test. Now we are going to do our first phase run test of the drive on a motor that is uncoupled to check for its performance. We can see here that the motor is running. We'll monitor it for a while and then put it on a load test. As you can see, this drive is rated at 40 amps under load. Here you have the drive hooked up to the dynamometer, and we have it under a full load test. As we can see from the data display on the keypad, we are pulling around 40 amps. This is how we get a full load on this drive. As a result, we know that this unit will perform in the customer's facility under normal operating conditions. This is the second phase of our VFD testing. Once testing is complete, the unit will be cleaned and shipped out to the customer. Thank you for watching.